everybody. Andy Gutierrez from StarWars.com. I am here live with Daisy Ridley, and we are going to answer some of your questions from at home to celebrate the home entertainment release of Star Wars The Force Awakens. It's now coming to HD, DVD, and Blu-ray. So, Daisy.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming here.
My pleasure.
How's it going?
Very well.
Good, good. Do you want to just get into it?
We don't
have a whole lot of time, so.
Let's do it.
Okay. Sorry, R2. So strange. All right. All right, our first question comes from Joel Westward from the UK.
Hey, Joel.
Joel asks, does Harrison Ford drive a Ford? Does Carrie Fisher eat fish? Does Mark Hamill eat ham sandwiches?
Great question, Joel. I can confirm that Harrison Ford drives a Ford, Carrie Fisher eats fish, and Mark Hamill eats ham sandwiches.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Huh.
Hit the nail on the head.
Yeah, right away.
Yeah.
All right, off to a good start there. Thanks, Joel. Let's, wanna pick it?
Sure.
Okay.
But you wanna read it?
Yeah, I'll read it.
Okay.
That's why they have me here. All right, our next question, also from the UK. Sammy Pasola wants to know, if you could tell your younger self one thing, what would it be?
Hey, Sammy. Nice question. I would say, if I could tell my younger self one thing, just keep doing what you're doing, because everything happens for a reason, and we all end up where we should, I believe.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Did you, when you were younger, did you know you wanted to be an actress, or was there something else like, oh, I want to be an astronaut?
I wanted to be a zoologist.
A zoologist?
Because I love animals, yeah.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's fair. What's your favorite animal?
A monkey.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. That would be fun. But I think you made the right
path.
Yeah, it worked out all right. All right. Sarah Beth from the US. What is one thing about the past women of Star Wars that you admire the most?
Hey, Sarah Beth. One thing I admire, probably their tenacity and strength, even in the face of, bad things happening.
Yeah. Leia.
She's
been through a lot.
She is tenacious.
Oh, yeah.
She is strong and funny and great.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. One of my faves as well. All right, cruising right along here. Let me get to the bottom. Okay. Domer from Russia.
Ooh,
yeah, we
hey,
are
Domer.
From all over the world here. Which color would you pick for your lightsaber if you could choose any one that you like?
Nice question. I've answered this before, so maybe I should go different this time. I would say Starfield. So it would be black. With moments of light.
That sounds really dangerous.
Dangerous?
Yeah.
I mean, lightsabers couldn't be more dangerous.
It's basically like
a chainsaw.
If you can't see a lot of it.
No, but if like the light is peeking out.
Okay.
Because I'm not talking about in a weapon wise, I'm talking about in fun wise.
Okay.
So if it's just a prop and not the real thing,
no.
Then it would be like a Starfield.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. It's always a strange question because it's like you want it to be maybe your favorite color, but mine's black.
Yeah, my favorite color is gray. Yeah.
That would be kind of a dull lightsaber.
Exactly.
All right, this one wants to be chosen, apparently. Tatiana, also from Russia.
Oh, hey, Tatiana.
What, we covered this. When you were a child, what did you want to become?
Zoologist.
Yeah.
So that's funny. Really cool and awesome.
I wanted to do that when I was a kid, too.
Did you?
Yeah. I love animals.
But now I'm not a fan of zoos, so
yeah.
It's gone totally full circle.
Yeah. Now you just want them where you're supposed
free.
To be. Evan, now from the US. Who was the biggest troublemaker on set of TFA? Talking goofs, pranks, and or shenanigans?
I would say probably myself and John
yeah.
are the biggest silly kind of thing.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I mean, Gary Fisher.
Gary
Fisher.
Oh, Gary.
Always around, getting in people's way, causing a ruckus.
With the
so
tongue.
Let's say Gary Fisher. Yeah.
So yeah. No pranks on set, huh?
Pranks. Well, Adam Driver jumps out of people and shouts things. That's terrifying.
Really?
But pranks? I don't know. No. Just fun.
Just good.
Just silly fun. Good old fun.
That's good.
Some of which you can see on the DVD.
Oh, hey.
Hey.
Special features.
There we go.
Yeah. you guys all seem like you have fun together. I mean, it's a really good group.
I was watching a special pre-release of the DVD with my mum, and she was like, does everyone believe what they're saying? And I'm like, we genuinely love each other. It's great.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
It's hard not to. You're working on Star Wars.
Exactly.
It's pretty cool. All right. Eamon Hurley from Australia.
Ooh, Australia.
Ooh, this is fun. Are you as mechanically minded or handy in real life?
Hey, Eamon. Well, you should ask. Last weekend, I wonderfully got sent a Star Wars PlayStation.
Oh, nice.
And last weekend, I was with two of my friends, and I was like, oh my God, I know what I'm going to do. Let me plug in the PlayStation. Had no idea how to do it. So I looked online, like, looked it all up, plugged it into the thing. It didn't work. So take into account, it's the same friend. So I don't know why she didn't say anything that day. Last weekend, she came over again, and I was like, oh, I wish the PlayStation would work. She was like, bet you put it in the wrong socket. It literally took her 2 seconds and then it worked.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, firstly, you could have said that last weekend. But secondly, proves that I am no way mechanical,
right.
Technological.
You won't be fixing any hyperdrives or...
No. Like, I can scrub well, so I can scrub the thing that I had found, and then someone else can put it in the thing and make the thing work.
That's fair.
Yeah.
That's kind of like me. I love this little Archie cookie jar, it's so funny.
I know. If everyone else can take it out.
Might. Alright, Zikri from Malaysia.
Oh, what a great name.
Yeah, I hope I said it right. Sorry. How do you feel when you're actually wielding a lightsaber?
You actually feel as epic as you think you would feel. They're heavy. So it's difficult, and it took a lot of training
mm-hmm.
with our incredible stunt team to make sure we were wielding it in the right way and not about to hurt anyone. But it feels amazing.
Yeah,
and because they light up, like
okay.
they genuinely are that colour.
Nice.
So
that gives it a more of a feel of realism.
Yeah.
Because back in the day, they were just reflective. They weren't.
Yeah, and because you can feel the light on your face, and especially that moment with me and Adam when we were just doing that moment when we're.
Yeah,
finding the force,
yeah.
Whatever. I shouldn't say that. Or whatever. Yeah, finding the force, because
yeah.
I don't know how to describe it.
That one moment.
You can feel the light, and it is that amazing thing of that you come to know these two colours as representing these two things.
Yeah.
And it does, it's just, yeah, it just feels amazing.
Yeah, I'm sure that helps, like, just really put you in the moment.
Yeah, and especially on that set, which is stunning. The whole thing, super cool.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
I feel like that probably would never get old.
I don't think so.
Yeah. You've got a little more time to do this.
A little more time. Hopefully fit some more things in.
Okay. Anne from Germany. What in your life has changed in the most positive way since you starred in Star Wars?
Firstly, hey. Hey, Germany. Has most changed? I think probably the opportunities I've been given
mm-hmm.
and the things I've been able to do. I obviously hadn't wielded a lightsaber before or been able to be in a film with people I genuinely love and adore and look up to
mm-hmm.
And seen amazing places. Like,
yeah.
it's just pretty amazing.
I mean, so you've gotten to see the world.
Literally seen parts of the world that I never ever thought I'd, like, not that I'd be able to, but I never thought I'd see them at this point in my life.
Right.
Just the people I've met have just been incredible behind the camera, in front of the camera, have nothing to do with the film world at all. Seen amazing things, met amazing people, and I get to do the thing that I love.
Yeah.
So it's all pretty positive.
It's pretty fantastic.
Yeah.
Where would you say is the coolest or your most favorite place that you've gotten to see?
I mean, I feel bad because it's a German person has asked me, but Japan.
Okay, cool.
Was really amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, everything has been, but yeah, and I think because I went to Japan like quite early on, it was the first place I went to for the press tour.
Okay.
And so I was able to go and see Kyoto and just somewhere that I've read a lot about, and I love the culture, I love the food. Main thing.
Yeah.
So there.
That's cool.
Yeah.
And then you had a premiere event there as well, right?
We did.
Yeah,
and it was great. And I felt fancy. Actually, I think that was my first, like, red carpet. And I was just
really?
so terrified. It was unbelievable. But then I got there and I was like, oh my god, it's great.
And you get to wear fancy stuff.
Exactly.
That's a cool thing.
Thanks for all the cool clothes, you guys.
Sarah McLean from the UK. What advice would you give to anyone hoping to be an actor?
Oh, Sarah, I do not know. I'd say just keep doing what you're doing. Keep loving what you do. Don't give up. It will be tough at times and then very rewarding at others. And if no. Yeah, just keep going.
Yeah.
Do or do not, there is no try.
There you go. Nice. Valuable life lesson there.
Yes.
Now, how long have you been acting? Were you doing it as a child?
No. No. I went to a performing arts school, so I was doing it there. But I'm professionally just a few years.
Wow.
Also, luck is like a genuine thing. And I know people, you know, are like, no, no, it's not. But, Yeah. I think luck will make things potentially happen sooner, like they did for me, but perseverance will make things happen ultimately.
Yeah. When you auditioned for Star Wars, did you know you were auditioning for Star Wars?
Yes.
Yeah, you did. Yeah. Oh, wow. No pressure.
Yeah, but I didn't know what I was auditioning for.
Okay.
And like, as in the role and everything. Or... Yeah, yeah, yeah. And when I read the script, I was like, oh, God. Oh, God, I can't do this. Oh, my God.
I can't imagine that amount of pressure. I feel like that would be worse than like your first day on set. Because you have to
I don't know, because the whole process took such a long time. It was like just a huge roller coaster that never ended for that whole time. And then the first day on set.
That's gotta be.
Yeah. But then you're surrounded by great people. You're like, this is really cool, even though it's so scary.
And like having John there, who's also like, you know.
John is brilliant. He's like my brother.
He's fantastic.
It's just been glorious
to get to do that together.
Because like it's obviously been like a whole group thing, but we work together so much to like have him and to genuinely like love him as much as I do, and we get on so well. And we come from very similar places. Like our families are very close, and that's like our main important thing in our lives. And which is funny, seeing as we were both playing things that have no families.
Yeah.
Like, you know, in Seven, we find our families. To have them there has just been brilliant.
That's great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Did I answer the question?
Yeah.
I can't remember what it was.
What advice would you give to the young?
Is that where it starts?
It's where it started. But,
oh my god.
Rambling.
There you go.
Sorry.
Rambling.
Back on topic now. Jake, also from the UK.
Repping.
I feel like I already know the answer to this one.
Okay.
Do you prefer coffee or tea?
Oh, because I just told you. Well, tea, but funnily enough, my favourite tea is green.
Oh, okay.
I do love green tea with honey, because my dad has builder's tea with honey, so honey was always the sweetener of choice.
Mm-hmm.
Green tea with honey is absolutely delicious if you haven't tried it. See, Twinings go up, the sales peak. Coffee, I love coffee, but it makes me very jittery,
And
I'm already quite a jittery person. Like last week, I was filming and I did have a coffee, and everyone was like, shh, stop talking.
Your lightsaber's like shaking.
Hey, Luke.
We're cruising here. I think there's a lot of questions in here, so that's good. Okay. Gabriel from Brazil.
Ooh, nice. Hey, Gabriel.
What do you like best about Ray? And what do you both have in common?
I like best that Ray is very hopeful, and that even though she's been alone for such a long time, and even though the journey is quite difficult, she just keeps going, and she's just trying to do the right thing. And it's funny, because when people talk about her being a hero and everything, I don't actually think that's, in my mind, that's never what she was, because she's just trying to carry on and trying to help the people around her.
She's a survivor.
Yeah. Right. The things we have in common, our faith.
That's a good one. Not the mechanical abilities.
I would say getting attached to people.
Yeah.
Yeah. The course of the film is 2 days?
Really?
Is it even 2 days?
Oh, no.
It's like a short amount of time. Ray and Finn, BFFs.
Right away.
Ray and Han, Ray and Chewie, BFFs. Her and Leia, first time they meet, hug, hug, hug. That's like me. Like, if I like someone, I'm like, oh my god, be my friend.
Oh my god, Chewie. And he's a hard sell. He doesn't like everybody.
He does like me.
Yeah, he does like you. Did you get a Wookiee hug?
I took a Wookiee hug.
That must be amazing.
And then there's the man behind the mask, and they're
here.
Just as brilliant.
Yeah.
Peter and Jonas, they're just as brilliant as Chewie.
That's so cool.
Just a big old loving.
That's, you know, that's...
And we're feeling the love from you guys.
Yeah, the fans have really, really attached themselves to John.
It's
a really positive
way.
It's really fun to watch. Oh, we already answered that.
Oh no.
Sorry. Okay. Sinjin from the US.
Oh gosh.
This is a question that I have personally too, so I'm glad we're asking it.
Okay.
What did that magic space bread taste like?
Hey,
I love the polystyrene.
You know what's funny is that I try not to eat bread because it makes me very tired, but obviously I still crave it. But it's just something I get, like I nap all the time anyway. Like I just don't need to be more tired than I usually am. And that day, the polystyrene bread. Well, the bread was one thing, and then the other green
thing.
So the green thing was halloumi, and it was delicious. And the green space bread tasted like bread with green food coloring.
sorry to
ruin that. It was delicious, but I did do that scene quite a few times, and by the end of it, I was like full.
Yeah.
And there was actually another bit when we were around the table, and I had to eat, I was like, oh, brilliant, because we had to sit at the table all day, and I was just like, I'm always hungry too. And so I was eating, and I think someone had said, like, maybe you don't want to eat too much. And I was like, oh, it's fine. And then after you do a few takes and all the different angles, you're like, oh, I don't want to eat this food again.
You, like, had, like, four apples.
Oh, no, it was all sorts of things. It was like a concoction of things.
I saw fans, like, trying to figure out what it was, and it was, like, a half of an apple and some Romanesco broccoli on
there
top.
There was Romanesco.
That is
because
so
I had
cool.
to ask what it was.
That's cool.
But, no, the space bread, it tastes like, it was good. It was good. Our wonderful props team really looked after me.
Nice.
And gave me some tasty treats.
Nice.
Yeah.
And that effect was so cool.
Oh my gosh. So and everyone couldn't believe it was real.
I know.
It was epic.
That's so cool.
But what was actually terrifying is the halloumi was cooking next to me and it was hot.
Oh.
So I was like, oh! I knew there was like a time limit of getting the halloumi on my plate for the bread to be there.
Uh-huh.
Stress.
Well done.
Secrets of the Force Awakens.
Well done. See, acting.
Acting.
It's tough. It's tougher than
what
you think.
I spent all those years at Fumi Arts.
So you could grab the
bread. Me on screen.
Okay. Josh Woodhouse from the US. How hard was it keeping your lips sealed to your closest friends and family about what was in Star Wars 7?
About what was in it?
Yeah. I mean,
at the time, it wasn't. Because I would get home and my dad likes the technical side of things, so I would talk to him about that. And then I could talk, I would tell my family who I was working with. But now looking back, I don't know, there are things that happen that I'm like, oh my god, yeah, god, we did a good job. But it was like there were so many of us keeping that secret.
Yeah.
And people who knew far more than I did, who had been keeping it for far longer. They'd started writing the story years ago.
Right.
And the artists and everything had started working on all the concept art and everything way before.
Yeah.
And also then we didn't know what would end up in the film.
Right.
Because, you know, they have to make choices occasionally. But it was actually okay. But funny enough, this one, I think because now I'm not in this like, oh, what's going on? Like, I feel a bit more centered. Now I'm finding it more like, oh, sometimes I say things and I'm like, oh no, I can't talk about this again. It's weird. Switch.
Do you find yourself kind of not wanting to know certain aspects of what's going to happen or what's going on?
No,
because,
I like to know.
You like to know.
I'm one of those people that I get FOMO, fear of missing out. And I always like to be part of it. So even when I'm not filming, even the scenes I'm not in, I like to be on set just to like feel the vibes and see what everyone else is doing.
Yeah.
And just because I think that would be so weird. I'm sure that is what people do, but then you go and see a film and you don't know what happens in the other half of the film that you're not in, which must be like really weird.
I can imagine.
But no, I like to know.
That's, yeah.
Yeah. How could you not? It's Star Wars.
Right? I'd be like flipping through the script.
Yeah. Oh my god, what happens at the end? Ah! Han Solo. Not a spoiler anymore, because we all know.
Oh, god.
That was
still,
hard.
It's still
and it was
stings.
Sad. Yeah.
Stings.
The first time when we went to the scoring and they were scoring that part, and obviously it was only John Williams who had the screen in front of him.
John Williams. Oh my
gosh. I know, everyone in the orchestra. I think because you can hear it in the music that something huge is happening, but they didn't officially know because they weren't watching. I had to leave the room because I started crying. Because it was the first time I went and saw them doing it, but it was the first time I saw it.
All together.
And every time, I think I cried every time. I've seen the film 4 times and I cried every time.
You know what gets me about that scene? It's like the moment is really sad, but it's when Leia reacts to it. I'm just like, oh my god.
I know, and she just knows.
Yeah.
But at least her and Han had
reconciled a
connected.
Little bit,
yeah.
Oh man, that gets me every time.
I know.
Okay. Wait, Law Smith from UK. Were you nervous when you first started filming The Force Awakens?
Yes. Like, it's funny because I saw my Godfathers just before I got cast, and they were like, oh my god, you're like a rabbit in the headlights. Like, I honestly was like, what is going on in my life? It's very much, and I think even now, like, I feel much more cool about it. But I still think in 10 years I'll look back and think,
yeah,
because obviously you're experiencing it, but now I wish I'd kind of been more present instead of just like freaking out about everything going on.
I can imagine that it's hard to stay present because you're go
but the team I had around me, especially my hair, makeup and costume, because they're with me all the time, Lisa, Amanda and Callie, they really kept me together.
That's good.
Yeah, because there are really moments when you feel awfully insecure and vulnerable and you wonder why you got picked. But those women really kept me together. And then having JJ and Kathy and everyone making me feel like it was okay.
Yeah.
And like, you know, they made the choice for a reason and everything. And you're like, oh, okay, this is cool. And also then you realize, because I remember saying to JJ, I was like, do you ever just think, what am I doing? And he was like, I think it all the time. And then you realize that everyone feels like that.
And
it's everyone's work that's on display.
Yeah.
Just because we're on the screen, like focus put his work on screen, Serge, cameraman, sound, everyone's work is right there.
Yeah, that's why I always ask my friends at ILM, like, what is it like seeing your final project on the screen? It must be very surreal.
Yeah, and then you're like, oh my god, my performance. And then you're talking to someone and they were looking at the hair, or you're talking to someone and they were looking at the set, and you're like, oh yeah, because people look at the different things. So I think we're united in our nervousness. And also the everyone wanted to make sure we did a really good job for the fans. And so it's very nice to know that paid off.
It did. Totally did. Okay. Alex from the US. Your workout regimen in preparation was 4 hours a day, 4 days a week. That's insane. And awesome. Oh.
Thanks.
What is the exercise or drill that you love to hate?
That I love to hate? The thing is, I have a bad wrist, so I can't put...
Oh.
It's like, I don't know if you can see, like I have ganglions, not there. So I can't put weight on my left hand like that.
So like push-ups.
So I can't do press-ups, which... push-ups in American terms,
darn.
Which is the thing that I think is like a great way of showing strength, but I hated them.
Mm-hmm.
I love to hate. Maybe like, or I hate to love, maybe like running, because now I've got more into sprinting, I like that, but running I was like, oh, I find it like sometimes I feel like my brain is rattling in my skull,
because
there's not enough there to fill it up. But then I always feel really badass.
Yeah.
Like I'm like, oh yeah.
Yeah, you get up and you're like,
running.
Kind of.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, I only ever do 5 minutes. It's got to be said. But you get off the treadmill or you stop running and you're like, you feel powerful.
Yeah.
And then you realize. And then it's like that incredible thing of like, you look at like the Paralympics and you think the incredible things a human body can do. And then you just get that surge of feeling like, wow, look at what someone with like no leg can do.
Yeah.
And then I just feel lucky that, you know, we're all capable of doing the things we do, and it makes it better.
It's See, I saw one of your Instagram videos where you're running with the parachute. Like, yeah. That looks like so much fun.
That was fun. That was fun. And also, and then it's the thing, because we're not where I was doing it, there's people walking around, so I'm like dying.
Like, I look like such a
like, hey, you guys, I'm trying really hard, working really hard.
That's awesome, though.
Yeah.
It's, was that something that you were into, like, before?
No.
You
know, and that's a weird thing, because my friend had to explain to me what netball is the other day. Like, I knew what it was. I don't know if you have that in the US.
Describe it.
It's like, you throw it, you throw the ball. This shows how sports are. Oh my god! You throw the ball, and but when you catch the ball, you can only take like 2 steps
and
you
pivot
or something. Handball.
Handball.
So and it's really sad because I always thought that maybe in a group sport that would be like a really good thing for me because I like to be part of a team.
Mm-hmm.
But I never really did sports till now, and I feel like now I really like it. I might have been an athlete. No, maybe not. That's a bit hopeful.
All right, Tom from the UK.
Oh gosh.
Can you please just come around for tea with my family? We all love Star Wars and we can have a lightsaber battle after.
Hey Tom, you were not the first person that's asked me to tea. I got invited to tea by another boy who's very sweet too. Right now, aside from this lovely interview, Q&A thing, I am filming episode 8. So I'm pretty busy. But have your people contact my people. Let's see what we can work out.
Yeah,
and I love how that's definitely a British person.
It's totally
like
right.
Come to
tea. Always, yeah.
And I have been doing baking, so I could bring a cake. But again, we've got to fit it into the schedule, and we've got to work around you. I don't know what commitments you have. School, after school clubs. I'm presuming you're at school. Maybe you're not at school. If you aren't, I'm really sorry. Maybe you have work. So we just got to work it out time wise.
Yeah. You can watch like Bake Off. Together. Is there
no, the thing is, I can't talk when I'm watching the baby.
It's so good.
There's also a new one that's called Creme de la Creme, which is highly stressful because it's
really?
Professionals. But no, I can't. I'm
You're
not
like
great at. Yeah, with Bake Off, I can't do two things at once. Like the phone's away, because once two of my friends came around and I was trying to watch it, and I rewatched the entire thing after they'd gone. So I was like, I've not heard a thing. So Tom, we couldn't watch the Bake Off, but we could have a Bake Off.
Let's get that on camera. That would be fun.
Yeah.
Benjamin Dolk from Sweden.
Oh, hey Benjamin.
What do you think you would do if you weren't an actress? Now, at this point.
I've got the travel bug again. I think honestly seeing all those amazing places in the past year has made me want to travel again. So right now, I think I would want to go to another country and set up a business. Somewhere warm, perhaps water sports or something.
Nice. What kind of business?
Or something that protects, you know, like conservation.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool.
When my sister went traveling, she did something in South America and it was like a conservation project. That kind of stuff sounds great.
Yeah. Very rewarding.
Yes.
It'd be nice to like see results. All right. We have time for one more.
Okay.
Do you want to pick it?
Sorry to whoever we haven't picked. Here we go. This one's peeking at me. All
right. Last question. Dylan Craig from the UK. Which are you enjoying working on more? Episode 7 or episode 8?
Dylan, what a question. They're honestly just two very different things. 7 was like the beginning of the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it was terrifying and incredibly rewarding. And I felt like I, you know, pushed myself in beyond boundaries I thought I had and all that kind of stuff. And now I feel more together and I feel more present, and I now look at things and think, how are people going to react to that? Because of the way people have responded to Ray, I now feel more like Carrie calls herself the custodian of Leia, and now I feel like the custodian of Ray, and I understand what people loved in 7, and so I feel like I'm carrying that responsibility with me, which is nicer because I feel like I'm more part of it. I don't know. But I couldn't say I'm enjoying either one more. It's all this incredible journey.
Yeah.
And if I am in 9, you know, all three are gonna, it's all one amazing journey that involves thousands of people, that's leading to the end of 9, but the whole thing is like this wonderful, joyous experience. And I think of 7, 8, and 9 as parts of one experience. They're not like three different ones.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm loving it all.
And no more staring contests.
Oh, the staring contest continues.
Do you and Mark find yourself staring at each other sometimes?
Every now and again, I'm gonna say, Mark.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for taking your time on your busy schedule to come and do this.
Absolutely. I had a ton of fun.
And thank you all at home for all of your questions. You know, check out Star Wars The Force Awakens when it comes out on digital, DVD, and Blu-ray. And yeah, thanks.
May the Force be with you.
May the Force be with you.